Hello everyone, this is Prasad Banerjee from Digit.in. So the Xiaomi Mi 3, it runs on the Mi UI 5. It is Xiaomi's own UI. The operating system is of course Android. It's KitKat 4.4.2. But the UI on this phone is called Mi UI 5. And to be honest, this UI probably lets you do more than any other UI will ever let you do. So let's start with an overview of the UI and let's see what all we can do. So this is the lock screen on this phone. The lock screen, you see, this is your unlock button. You can press this. If you move this to the top, you get to the camera. To the left, you get to the call phone app. To the right, you get to the message app, and you take it to the bottom to unlock it. But that is not all that you can do. If you double tap this, it changes to your music. And you can use this to toggle your music. So that is a very good, I think, a very good and functional thing that Xiaomi has added to the Mi UI, because you can play music without unlocking your phone. And if you look at this, you double tap this, it comes back here. Also, another thing this does is the minute you press your hand here, if you have a message, a text message that is, it shows up here on the middle of the screen. The text message will show up. You can of course pull down your notifications and screen to check your notifications and everything as well. Also, the lock screen also does, when you're at the lock screen, you can press the home button and keep pressing it to start the flashlight. As you can see, the flashlight on the phone right now is on, and the screen changes to this. And the screen changes to the flashlight torch. You can switch off the torch by simply doing this, and it comes back to the lock screen. From the lock screen, of course, you unlock it, you go to the home screen. The first thing you will notice about the MIUI home screen is that it is very similar to what you see in iOS, in the sense that the app drawer that Android usually has is not there on MIUI. Similar, this is also something that you will find in Lenovo phones here. So you see the clock, this is the clock widget on the top. This also lets you do a lot of things. For example, if you're on a screen and if you want to say move this gallery app, if you want to move the gallery app to another screen, what you would usually do is you would long press the app and you would move it to the edge of the screen and wait for the screen to move, which can be cumbersome sometimes. But in the MIUI, what you can do is you long press the app, you drag it, and you can just use another finger to move the screen and place it in whatever screen you want to place it. This also is a, I think, a functional thing. One more thing you can do to move it is you can just long press on the home screen itself. So long pressing on the home screen unveils these options at the bottom. So you see the move apps. So on the move apps, you can just select whichever app you want to move. You can go to whichever screen you want to place it on, and you can just select the app and it will get placed. Another thing you can do is if you want to place two or three apps on one screen, you can swipe from the left. It groups the apps and just click, it moves it to the screen. So this is another very easy way, simple way to move the icons from one screen to another without, you know, making it very cumbersome. Long pressing the home screen also gives you these the widgets, so you can add your own widgets to your home screens. It's got many widgets. The wallpapers that you can change, you can, and it gives you a preview. You can choose whichever wallpaper you want to put on the phone, and say yeah. The minute you press back, it asks you whether you want to apply it. It's applied. You can also change the home screen toggle effect. The home screen transition effects. So if you do crossfade, it's giving you a preview of what is going to happen. This is what slide will look like. This is what overslide will look like. And rotate, cube effects, rotate. You can again press back and the effect is set by itself. So as you can see, my home screen right now is on rotate. That is another feature of the home screen. One more thing that the home screen gives you is, for example, say if I want to delete an app, say I want to delete this the Flipkart app. So if I long press this, in usually in Android you would want to put it here to remove the icon, but in MIUI when you put it here, it automatically asks you where you want, whether you want to uninstall Flipkart or not, the whichever app you choose. So you can of course choose uninstall or cancel. If you choose cancel, it comes back here. If you choose uninstall, it's uninstalled. One problem with this UI can be that, you know, when you have many apps, your screen can be cluttered. For that, what you can do is put icons, similar apps into folders like this. But still, I think if you are one of those people who load a lot of apps on your phone, then your screens might look a little cluttered. Still not a very big issue though. So next up that we can talk about in the MIUI is the messaging app. So the messaging app is basically the normal, your normal messaging app. You have your new message, you can get to your new message. You can see it shows the last six contacts that you have talked to or messaged, so that you can choose them very easily. But the best part about the messaging app here is if you pull down, you keep pulling, you see you unveil this lock icon. So yeah, this unlocks your private messaging, which can be locked with a pattern of your choice. So say you put the pattern and it gives you to get you to the messaging private messaging screen. Here what you can do here is you can go to private messaging settings and you can add your own contacts. So here, when you're here, you can just press add private contact, go to your contacts and select whichever contact you want to add to private message. So what will happen is when you do get a private message, your phone will just tell you that you have a message. It won't tell you who the message is from or what the message is. Also, the preview that it shows on the lock screen, that preview will also just say that you have a message. It won't tell you who or what. So that I think is a very functional feature and something, you know, it could be very useful for a lot of us. So next you see the camera app. The camera app on this phone is normal, the way most camera apps look like. You can go into settings and one thing Xiaomi has added with the MIUI is the camera app itself has a scan QR code option. So the QR code scanner is integrated into the camera app, which means you do not have to install a separate app for QR codes. Again, this is something that might be useful to a lot of you because even though in India we don't use QR codes very often, you know, we do need to use it from say once or twice. And it's very, you know, you do not want to download an app that you will use say once or twice. So it's better that it's integrated into the camera. And something that I think most other manufacturers will start doing now that Xiaomi has done it. If you go into advanced settings, this is a pretty funny and nifty feature. It's got face recognition. So what this does is when you have the front camera on, the front camera will display your age and gender. Whoever is in front of the camera, it shows the age and gender. This though is pretty inaccurate. You do not have, it doesn't show you the right age, although the gender it does get right. Next, let's look at the security app that you get with the MIUI. Here you have options like cleaner, data usage, block list, permission, virus scan and power. So cleaner is, of course, it's powered by CleanMaster. It will scan through your phone and tell you how much space you can free up. And you can, based on that, you can delete or whatever you want to do with those apps. As you can see, it's got some cache, add files, packages, residuals, these options. These will also show you similar things wherever you can free space up. The block list is you can add people from your contacts to your block list and their messages and calls will of course be blocked. The power manager shows you how much time your battery will last, although let me tell you that the power manager is very very inaccurate. The phone right now is on 21% battery and it says 15 hours battery life. And the virus scanner of course scans for viruses, it's self-explanatory. The main two very useful options that you get here are the data usage app. the data usage app basically monitors how much data you're using. And what you can do is you can go into the app, choose restrict here, and it gives you this list. So it's got all your apps with data and Wi-Fi. So if, say, we want to give Flipkart the option to access our data, so I just click here and it goes to Wi-Fi. I can just click here again and Flipkart is not being allowed any access. So for this, I think it's a very easy method to, you know, allow and not allow access to your apps. In many other phones, this is a little cumbersome. People don't understand what exactly to do. So this makes it much easier. You can set your mobile data usage here and the phone will ping you when you reach that usage. The permissions app is, again, this also makes it very easy. So your phone, the apps on your phone need a few privileges and permissions. Those permissions, what we usually, many of us do, is we grant them automatically. But, you know, not all apps need to send an SMS or, say, make a phone call or phone monitor calls, things like that. So say I want to set SMS privileges. You've got your question marks here and the tick next to the Me Talk. So what happens is, Me Talk is right now set on allow. If you set it on allow, you get the green tick. You can either deny permission to Me Talk. Say we are doing it for Hangouts. You can deny permission to Hangouts. If you deny, the cross comes up. And if you do, say you're not sure whether Hangouts needs to send an SMS or not. In this case, we are usually stuck with other phones. What you can do is set it on ask. In this case, what will happen is, if Hangout does try to send an SMS, MIUI will automatically ping you and ask you whether it should send out an SMS or not. Again, this makes it very easy for you to manage your own phone compared to many others. Another thing about the MIUI is the notes app here. So say you want to take down a quick note and you don't exactly want to go into the notes app and make a note. So what you do is you just swipe up and this comes up. So we take down the note and you press back and your note is saved. You can do the same thing with your music app. The music, this small window comes up. You can just play your music. You can seek it from here. And you can press back when you want to close it. That again makes it a little easier. Not something that, you know, makes it a lot easier or anything. But it's a pretty useful new addition to the UI. Your notifications toggle is pretty much the same. You have the notification screen and you have the toggle screen. You can also swipe between them. This you can change. You can change from the notification settings. So for the settings, you go to more here. And as you see the notifications option here, you go here, you can change it to bar or page. So when you go to bar, your notifications start looking like this. You can toggle. And slide through it and access your notifications. It also shows you your data limit and how much you've used here in a ticker. And pressing this will take you to the data usage app. So again, if you press more, another thing you can do is you can switch on show connection speed. What this will do is, right now we're not connected to a data connection. Here on the top here, it'll start showing what the connection speed is for your whatever connection you're connected to. Not something we all use, but, you know, something that we could end up needing sometime. So the MIUI, as you can see, there are a lot of things that you can do in this UI. If you don't like the look of your screen, another thing you can do is, you see the themes app here, you can go into the themes app. And you can change the theme whenever you want. The company provides a lot of themes and also the community itself makes themes for it. So this is a very fresh new look at Android. Something I think something that was missing for a long time. People were starting to get bored of the same old themes over and over again, the same old UIs over and over again. So the MIUI gives you a very new look and something that you haven't seen before probably. But the downside is that you will need some time to learn this, probably even a month to learn the entire UI. Again, if you're okay with that, I think this is a very good UI to work with. The MIUI is also available on the Play Store as an app. You can download it, but all the features, the complete feature set of the MIUI is available only on Xiaomi phones.